Hi everyone, good morning everyone. This is Kanna Babu from Satya Technologies. I think in the last video, I stopped in the middle. We are discussing about the architecture of SOA, right? So just I will refresh watch here. Service provider will create the service. Service provider will deploy the service on the server. Service provider will create one WSGL file. WSGL is an XML file. It conserves the information of the web service, like service URLs, class names, method names, input parameters, return types, port numbers, the total information of the web service. Is it clear? It was kept on where? Server in WSGL file. And then service provider will deploy this WSGL file in UDDA. UDDA is a service registry, which will provide services to n number of client applications. UDDA is a service registry. Is it clear? And then the notes we are writing here. Point number one, service provider will create the web service. Service provider will deploy the service on the server. Service provider will create WSGL file. WSGL is an XML file. WSGL is used to describe the web service. WSGL is a manual for web service. WSGL conserves the information of the web services, like service URL, class names, method names, input parameters, return type, information, all this stuff. Is it clear? UDDA is a universal discovery description integration. Is it clear? UDDA is an XML registry. UDDA is a service registry. UDDA is used to advertise the WSGL file. Is it clear? And a service provider will place the WSGL file in UDDA. UDDA will give WSGL URL to service provider. Service provider will provide WSGL URL to service consumers. The service consumer must purchase the WSGL URL. Okay, service consumer must purchase WSGL URL from service provider. And then what will happen, you know, the service consumer will connect to UDDA and download the WSGL file. Download the WSGL file. Point number 9, I will try to write. Service consumer will connect to UDDA and download WSGL file and download WSGL file. Service consumer is a developer who is developing web application. Okay, na? Service consumer is a developer who is developing web application. Are you following? So now what will happen, you know, service consumer will read WSGL file, and he will consume the web service in web application. Is it clear? For that, he will write some code. This is service. Now this is your web application. Your web application kept in another server. This is your web application. Web application is in another server. Web service is in another server. Both are in two servers. Okay, now this is server one. This is what? Server one, you can tell. Yes or no? This is your code actually. This is your WSGL file. I will cut and I will keep here so that you can easily understand. This is WSGL file. Okay. WSGL file. Okay, now. Now what I'm telling here you can see, this is your server two. So server to server communication is required here. This is one server, this is another server. Server one and server two. So server to server communication is required. Okay, now server one and server two communication is required. In middle some network will be there. Some network is required to create the communication between this server. Okay. So we need to transfer the communication between these two servers is by using HTTP protocol. HTTP is a communication protocol which is used to create the communication via internet. Via internet, if you want to transfer the data or if you want to get the data, we must have the knowledge on HTTP. And the data transfer will be in the form of SOAP. So SOAP and HTTP, these are important. SOAP is simple object access protocol. SOAP is something like message transfer protocol. Message transfer protocol. HTTP is like some communication protocol. If you want to transfer the data via network, HTTP is required. Generally, we cannot transfer objects via network. Okay, that is the reason we have to take the support of serialization, deserialization, all this stuff. Object we cannot transfer via network. Converting the object into stream of bytes, that concept is called serialization. Reverse process is called as deserialization. Different types of serializations are binary serialization, XML serialization, and SOAP serialization. Okay, this is what now, sir, where WCF will come, this is your WCF service. Within the application also you can create, this is your WCF service. Service provider will create the service, and then service provider will create one WSGL file, and WSGL file is deployed on what? UDDA, service consumer means web application developer. He will consume the web service and he will try to what? Consume it. So server to server communication is required, data transfer purpose XML is required, because XML cannot transfer via network. Okay, so we are, a special offer is running at Satya Technologies, that is 9th September, tomorrow. September, August, this one. September. Okay, now tomorrow we have a new batch is there, ASP.MVC, ASP.NET, ADO.NET, Link, Entity Framework, Design Patterns, Web API, WCF, Angular 10. WCF is free anyway. Web API and Angular 10. This all total package is 6,000 rupees. So anybody are interested to join this course, tomorrow morning 8:30, MVC new batch is there. And 10:30, Angular new batch is there. Angular complete, Angular 10. Duration is 40 days. Complete Angular course we will cover here. And here we are going for what? Web API and all the stuff. Is it clear? You can... purpose is same, but mobile application development, mostly it is recommended to go for web. Nowadays, web API only powerful. WCF is old, web API is the latest one. Just go to satyatech.com, go to online schedules. There you can check. Today, first class also can attend, just first class only also. If you missed any yesterday's class, watch the video in YouTube. This is the ASP.MVC link. You can just click on register, so that you can fill your details and check your Gmail. You'll get the link and you can join this class. ASP.MVC tomorrow, 8:30 a.m. In the same manner, Angular 10 is also there, my batch, 10:30 a.m. Angular 10 by Kannababu, you can join that batch also. Free demo you can attend. Morning, 10:30 a.m. Click on register. Yes, sir, no. Did you understand? So this is just the architecture of SOA. If you anybody want to watch the videos, you can just go to YouTube and type satyatechnologies.com. There you can find the live classes will be going on. So this is today's class. You can see here. Satya Technologies website, you can watch here. The classes you can find. Today's class, you can subscribe. You will get the notification also. Okay. Anymore, yesterday's class only here. I'm telling Nani, yesterday's class only. It is there. You can watch in satyatech.com website. That's it. That is how you can work with SOA architecture. So now if you have any doubts, you can ask me. I'll clarify. Please. Ask your doubts. You can clarify. Directly you can ask. No need of chatting. Okay. You can ask.
What about the syllabus for yesterday? It is hosted in the,
sorry.
The syllabus for yesterday for the WCF. It is on the group of same group for the .NET.
Yeah, WCF WhatsApp group, that is same. Telegram group I will post, or you can join my Facebook group. World of .NET group is there. There you can.
Okay. Now regarding it, which was WCF, it will now obsolete.
Can
right?
You speak loud? Can you speak loud? Speak loud.
Regarding yeah. WCF. Hello.
Yeah. Tell me.
Yeah, regarding WCF, it's now it will be coming obsolete.
WCF,
right?
This is today. WCF yeah. Is free today. We are not. This is not WCF. Is not completed. It will take 1 week to complete WCF. Demo examples, implementation, everything I will cover. You don't worry.
And also, it will be included as in the batch of MVC.
I didn't understand MVC.
Yeah, it will be also included in the batch of
Yeah, MVC. Yeah, this package, if you join the package, you will get MVC with Web API. Integration, everything I will show in this package only.
That's fine. Okay.
Yeah. Sir, hello. XML, I'll give some introduction on XML. Tell me.
సార్ ఇప్పుడు యాంగులర్ అనేది 10:30 అన్నారు కదా, అది టైమింగ్స్ ఏమైనా చేంజ్ అనేది లేదా సార్? బికాజ్ నాకు 10:30 కి అవ్వడానికి నాకు ఉండదు సార్ అందుకోసం.
యాక్చువల్లీ ఆఫ్టర్ SQL సర్వర్ బ్యాచ్ మార్నింగ్ 7:30 ఐ విల్ స్టార్ట్ వాట్ యాంగులర్ న్యూ బ్యాచ్. ఓకే
ఓకే,
యు కెన్ కంటిన్యూ దట్ బ్యాచ్ నో ప్రాబ్లం. యువర్ కార్డ్ ఇస్ వాలిడ్ ఫర్ 3 మంత్స్. హౌ మెనీ టైమ్స్ యు వాంట్ టు లిసన్ యు కెన్ లిసన్. ఓకే, ఇట్ ఇస్ నాట్ పాసిబుల్ ఫర్ 10:30, you join for what? 7:30 batch.
Okay,
I will start after SQL server, I will start Angular 7:30 batch. No problem.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you.
Any more doubts you have? Thank you.
Hello.
Yeah.
Sir, just like Angular and React.js and Node.js are trending in the market, so how WCF will be helpful for me to attending the class?
Yeah, actually WCF, apart from that, nowadays what is happening, you know, web application development is purely related to what? Full stack developer. Full stack developer means this is which application? Front end application, and this is what? Back end application. Okay, back end application, and this is what? Your database. Okay, and here your front end application is Angular or React.js. Angular or React.js. Your ASP.NET MVC, whatever it may be. Total application will not be developed in Angular. Some admin panels, they will go for MVC. Some user panels will go for Angular or some Xamarin forms. Okay, nah? Some iOS, some Android. This all comes under front end. It depends actually. Now this front end application must communicate with the back end application. Means in back end application, you have to create what? APIs. So very, very powerful web APIs. Web API is powerful. WCF, just knowledge is enough. Web API is very powerful. So that your front-end application will directly communicate with back-end application through APIs by using AJAX calls. And this APIs will communicate with the database, get the result, and convert the result in the form of JSON, and send the JSON result to your front-end application. And this front-end application will provide services to different client applications like browsers or mobiles. This is what the story. So this Angular, mostly you can use Angular React as a front-end application, and web APIs. It may be either Java or .NET or PHP. Anyone must learn. These APIs are common for everyone. Okay, this portion is Angular mandatory. Full stack developer means Angular with Java, Java full stack developer, Angular with .NET, full stack .NET developer, Angular without Java.NET, PHP, Python, that is called as a mean stack developer. MongoDB, Express.js, Angular, and Node.js. Your doubt is clarified?
Yes, sir.
So WCF is old actually web services. Now advanced is web API. RESTful services is very popular.
Actually, I haven't heard about this WCF earlier before, so that was...
You're from which background? .NET background or what?
I'm a front-end developer. I'm working in a small company.
Front-end developer, on which technology you're working?
Angular.
You're working on which technology?
Angular.
Angular means you must have the knowledge on full stack. Full stack means what? MongoDB.
Express, Angular, and Node.js.
Yep. So sometimes if your company... you have to consume these APIs that are developed in Java, .NET, etc. In that scenario, you must have the web API is more powerful than WCF. For you, if you learn, you will get some clarity. Otherwise, also no problem, directly learn APIs.
Okay.
In mean stack also, you will write APIs in Express.js.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you will write APIs in Express.js and you will invoke that APIs in your Angular.
Okay.
Express.js is a server-side framework now to communicate with MongoDB or MySQL database to get the data and send the result to the Angular services.
Yes, sir, I'm attending your classes. Your .NET and C# one, because I don't have any knowledge about backend technology and database.
Then better to learn. Tomorrow MVC is also there now. Only C#, no use again.
Okay.
C# is just a programming language support for... development. Web application development is more popular in .NET or Java.
Okay.
Without that idea, if you learn, means there is no use. Tell me, any more doubts you have? Okay, thank you. Tomorrow we'll continue. Bye.
Thank you.